So my talk is about education tools that is so important for us to dedicate time to understand what is education. Because sometimes we confuse education with instruction. So we can tutorize people do things for us as instructor, but education you have to do yourself, to extract from inside you, looking for it, looking for beautiful things that teach you in your daily life. So education, the process of knowledge, skills, values, and methods include teaching, training, storytelling, that I like very much, discussion, and direct research. Education frequently takes place under the guidance of educators. However, learners can also educate themselves. Education can take place in formal or informal settings, and any experience that has a formative effect on the way on things, feel, or acts may be considered educational. The methodology of teaching is called pedagogy. It is through education, more than instruction, that humanity will be transformed. It's not me that's saying that, it's Allan Kardec, when he codified the books and also the posthumous works, that is a book that was published after Kardec's death. So it's the second part of this book. You can read more or less a extracted part. In the book Posthumous Works, Allan Kardec declares that humanity will only be transformed by education. Disciple of the pedagogue Johann Pestalozzi, the French Hippolyte Léon Denisart Rivail, that we had the pleasure right now, a few minutes ago, to listen Charles, the beautiful talk, the beautiful biography, the beautiful news about his family, his life. So you have this wonderful encyclopedia in your hands. So the French Hippolyte Léon Denisart Rivail was an educator as well. Later on, he adopted the pseudonym Allan Kardec as codifier of Spiritism. A Pentateuch of moral and spiritual education was prepared by him with the support of the superior spirits, thus was born in the Spiritist doctrine, or the doctrine of spirits. That is, spiritualist philosophy under the support of the Spiritist science. In studies, we find the foundation of higher education, which is part of all the religions, creeds, spiritualistic philosophies, regardless of any forms of cults. God, the soul, immortality and future punishments and rewards, communicability with the so-called dead. So Spiritism can come and open everything for us. So we talk about the methodology. So Kardec used a very important methodology to bring towards the light this beautiful philosophy. He used a strict control, so the universal control of the Spiritist teachings. Kardec wrote the introduction of the gospel according to Spiritism, paragraph 7. As a complement of each precept, we have added some well-chosen instructions from among those dictated by spirits in various countries throughout different mediums. If they had been taken from only one origin, they would probably have suffered the influence either of the person or the ambient, whereas the diversification of origins proves that the spirit gives teachings without distinctions and that no one person is especially privileged. We should continue in what Kardec did in the past time, because nowadays one spirit dictates, one book is published, so sometimes with no this methodology, as Kardec did before, strictly knowing if everything is correct, and the information can come through the humanity. One tool, or a special tool, was Review Spirit. Review Spirit was a laboratory of the spiritual world that brings to Kardec everything that Kardec published. The public could read, could inform back Kardec, and that is the thing that he could introduce and form our codification. So Review Spirit, the Spiritist magazine, was a great instrument used by Kardec in the work of codifying Spiritism. It served as a laboratory of Spiritist theses, a means of capturing the reactions of the public, advertising tool, and information vehicle and defense of doctrinal postulates, becoming a unique repository of facts, reports, studies, discussions, and fundamental analysis of the Spiritist philosophy to organize the five books, the Pentateuch, and more books about what is Spiritism and the other books that came along. So here we have some magazine that is still available on the internet. You can find in Spanish, in Russian, and English, and French, and some numbers in German. It's still there. So these books are the ones that we use in our Spiritist studies. It's the basic thing for us. The first moment that Kardec wrote the Spirit book, he opened the window for humanity, for education, spiritual education, to understand what's going on in our life, about death, about reincarnation, about the methodology to speak with the spirits. So everything is comprised in these five books that we recommend as a Spiritist to everyone. Buy it, read it free on the internet. We have in our website, so you can download it from them, www.bas.org.uk. So you can even have our gospel that's published this year, translated by Janet Duncan, that teaches us the moral code of the universe. This code is not only for our planet. Jesus brought for us, for our planet, as he is the governor of our planet. But there are a lot of Christs on another planet that are using the same laws of God that are inside this precious book. So, my dear people, go there. So, the study of Spiritism offers a panoramic and spiritual view of eternal life based on the other of the subjects existing in the basic Allan Kardec books and complementary works. So our Spiritist Center now online, we have classes, free classes. You don't need to change your religion to study this philosophy. In our groups, we have people from the other religious background. They are really happy to learn a little bit more about the spiritual life. That is really an important thing that we can educate our children. Because educating ourselves, we can build inner peace in our family and in the world. I can share this. So as you can see here, the Spirit Book question 914, are humans becoming enlightened about spiritual things? They attach less value to material things. Next, it's necessary to reform the human institutions that entertain and excite the passions that depends on our education. So we must do all that we can to build peace in the world. Otherwise, it's impossible to enlighten ourselves and not be a peaceful person. That to be conquered, peace in the world, requires the involvement and participation of the whole society. And we must overcome attitudes such as complacency, passivity, indifference, and omission. On the other hand, it's also necessary to develop tolerance, related behaviors, respect, friendship, compassion, humility, kindness, responsibility, love, resilience, generosity, truth, gratitude, solidarity, and collaboration. If you really want the implementation of peaceful life to destroy selfishness. So, talking about peace, we can acquire our inner peace, inner state of calm, satisfaction and hope achieved with the practice of the personal virtues learned by spiritual education. So some people, they spend a lot of money paying things to do a relaxation outside, this and that, but you can do yourself. You can do self-studies. People that come to our immense congresses here in the UK, for example, they buy the books, they study themselves. They don't need to come to a spiritual center as a person, but they can acquire the knowledge of spiritual teachings and help themselves. Peace in the world, peace in the family, and peace in inner peace. So creation of a culture of peace in the home, stimulating open dialogue, mutual respect and effort to build a harmonious and balanced family life. Educating children, spiritual dialogues, free classes for families and children in our spiritual center in the world for free. You can find on the internet now, you can participate in kardec.org.uk, have a lot of addresses that you can participate. When I was looking for material to add in our information today about education, that we educate our children with the books, storytellers, etc., I found this person. She is the founder of a very important institution, the spiritualeducation.org. You can find the information, and she wrote a book that I'm interested, The Spiritual Child, that teaches us values, not only for a religious purpose, but for classes in the normal schools, and these are their project, this lady and the other people. So they are building information regarding how to bring spiritual knowledge, spiritual education inside the normal school that there is no religiosity as we have in Brazil, universities, colleges, scholar groups, etc. So in the Spirit Book, question 917, what is the means of destroying selfishness? Because we can educate ourselves to be no selfishness person. Of all human imperfections, the most difficult to uproot is selfishness, because it is connected to the influence of matter, from which human beings is still so close to their origin, cannot free themselves. We can say here now. Here we can, it's only as a matter of suggestion, you can find books in our website, books that can bring to your home, to your child, help to educate your child, talking about someone that already died or passed in the spiritual world, how to pray. So 30 prayers, so every day children can learn how to pray for a grandmother that is in hospital or for a pet that died. It's very nice to have these kind of things to help our children to know a little bit more, okay? Here, again, the Spirit Book was released in 1857. The medium books would have to be the following on the series, 1861, in order to enable the careful study of experimental aspects raised by exchange between the two planes. We are surrounded by spirits. We are learning and we are giving an examples how to teach others with our examples. When we enlighten ourselves with these books, or you enlighten yourself with something that is really good, how to behave, I described a lot of vicissitudes and a lot of good things to do and to be. These books are amazing, so you can really modify your life. Also, in order to educate ourselves, a tool of education is books. So there are books. These books here now that we have in our BAS bookshop, you can find on the internet, you can order, I can send it to you when you have time to go you know, these times of lockdown. And for next year, we have four books, actually, will be published in 2021. They are under revision right now. So, my dear listeners, I have to see my time here. So, I have 5 minutes already. I still have 5 minutes because I can't see you. I only see my screen. So, suggestion to you all is to promote the culture of valuing peace between children and adolescents, families. Find the online peace education. You can find us on the internet. You can teach and be part with your children, your young people, your teenagers online, learning about behavior. We have so many children, 13 years old, committing suicide right now, almost one every fortnight, that make me cry. And we can change the way the family are behaving, change the way to teach these children, change the way to behave with cuddle, with the dialogue. And the books are really helping a lot. So you can find the groups here on these two websites, because we have a treasure in our hands. So we can explore this treasure a little bit more. And I finished my talk right now and say thank you to all.